yes, and you might sometimes see some beautiful picture of Italy. So hopefully you will enjoy.
And there's this little clip from a certain movie. You have to work out what it's called, if you know it.
We will as well. Shall we start the PowerPoint?
Yes, Phil, please, Phil. Officer Dibble.
You're right.
Yeah.
Want me to move?
Oh, okay. Can you show us some thumbs up when you see the screen shared by Phil? You should see a flag and food from the world. Can you see
that? Can you all see the screen? You can.
Yeah.
Good.
Good.
Yeah.
So let me just reduce this so I can read. Well, that would be fun. So welcome to Food from the World, everyone. Nice to see you all. We are going to travel to Italy today, hopefully to see some sunshine and some warmth and have a feel of spring and summer because it is a nice and warm country.
Oh, wow. That's good.
Can we go to the next slide? Thank you. So does anyone know where Italy is?
If you know where Italy is, raise your hand. You can unmute your microphone.
You can see from the world map here. It's a tiny country in Europe. Shall we go to the next slide?
Yes.
Thank you. So do you want, I can move that if you want.
Italy is located in South End Europe. It's easy to spot it with its high heeled shape with two islands called Sicily and Sardinia.
So you can recognize it quite easily because it looks like a high heel shape. That's right.
Yeah.
Let's go to the next one. Do you know the capital of Italy?
Rome.
It was one of the questions from Alex quiz last week.
Stephen's got his hand up.
The answer is Rome. It's where the Leaning Tower of Pisa is.
What was the answer?
Rome.
Yay! Next slide, please. Do you want to go?
You can do this.
So, Rome is the capital of Italy. It is very famous for its historical sites and stunning architecture. So, the photo of the fountain is a very famous place called Fontaine Trevi.
Yes.
As well, we are going to see later the Colosseum and the Vatican and many other famous place that if you've been to Rome, you would have seen them. It's just beautiful for its history. So let's have a look at the next one. Thank you.
The Colosseum is an oval amphitheatre in the centre of the city of Rome.
And the Vatican is a small country in the middle of Rome. It's where the Pope lives. And where lots of famous paintings from Michelangelo are in the chapel.
Michelangelo.
Oh, thank you. Please.
Michelangelo. To his friends, Michelangelo.
You know him, right?
He came round and painted my roof once.
Amazing. Right, shall we get the next one?
Yes, Christina. Yes.
It's the floating city with 417 bridges and 350 gondolas.
So that is Venice. I know that some of you, like Maxine, you have been to Venice a few years ago. I don't know if you remember. Yeah, when you went on the cruise, you went to Venice.
Yes, I did.
And it was really beautiful because you could see lots of gondolas. Instead of cars, it is cars. It's gondola. There is no road. It's canals. Just a very special place. Emily says your mum went there. That's fantastic. Chef loved it.
I do remember.
Next slide, please, Phil.
What is Italy famous for? Shall we ask everyone?
Open up mics, please, Phil.
Food.
I can't open up mics. People will have to do their own.
So if you know what Italy is famous for, I've heard Kezia saying food, that's definitely a yes.
Question, Christian, hey, can my mum have the recipes of what you're going to cook this afternoon? Because my mum said she needs
recipes. We'll share the recipes next week, but the question is, does anyone know, what was the question, Christelle?
What is Italy famous for? What do you know about Italy? What do you think about when you think of Italy? Yes? Is there anyone? Or shall we just
shout it out?
It's famous for its pasta and pizza, and it's also Venice, where one of the James Bond movies was there.
Oh, yes, that's right. Right. Yeah, you're going to
go. Yeah, thank you, Alex.
It's not in Venice. It's not in Venice.
No, that's
it's
right.
Where the building collapses. I can't think what it was called.
That's right.
Wait, yeah, I think it's not a problem.
Anything else? Anyone else to discover?
No, no, there's another one.
Football, that's right, yes.
Can I just ask you, can you all mute your microphones unless you're going to, unless you've got something to say, because we're getting a lot of background noise behind people.
Sure, if you're willing.
So if I can ask you to mute your microphones, and then we will be able to hear people. Right, Vicky's got something to say.
I've been to Venice.
Have you? What did you think of it?
Lovely, beautiful place.
Yes. Have you seen all the famous masks for Carnival? All the costumes?
Well, I think, yes. I've got a book of it.
Have you? It is a beautiful city, isn't it? Very different than any others.
And Debbie's got something to say.
It's famous for its wine.
Wine, of course. Of course, Debbie knows that.
Yes, that's why they call Debbie the Prosecco Princess.
Well done, Debbie.
That's very true.
I remember before lockdown, Debbie, going to a Wetherspoons with you and Stephen, and you drinking a couple of glasses of Italian wine.
It was very nice wine.
You should book up your...
And Kirsty said that it is famous for gelato, which is ice cream. Very true. Definitely. They're amazing ice cream there.
And we're going to Dean first and then Emily. So, Dean, can you unmute?
I was just going to say I don't really drink like wine but as much. I only drink it on the occasion.
Well, there's some nice beers from Italy as well. A nice glass of Peroni or...
I've never been to Italy before.
No, neither have I. And Emily?
It's also famous for cheese.
That's right. Do you know any cheese?
I love cheese. There's so many cheese.
So do I.
My favourite things is cheese, pasta, pizza, all my favourites.
Well, you are half Italian, aren't you?
And Harriet's got something, I believe.
Some what, sorry?
Harriet.
I've been to Italy.
Well, what's it famous for? If you've been, tell us what's it famous for.
It's famous for its markets, because it has loads of markets there.
That's right. And beautiful ingredient for recipes on the market. That's true. Very true.
I like recipes.
Shall we have a look at the next one? Next page?
Yeah. Bear with me.
Thank you very much.
Oh, it's gone back to the beginning.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Well, I will.
You've already played it, Italy.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, well done.
It is a Mediterranean climate. It means it is sunny most of the year, perfect for sunny holidays.
Yeah, totally. Look at this beach and this countryside. Just make me want to be in the sunshine and in the warmth. Can't wait for the summer.
There's the Grand Prix of Italy, you dirty bugger. Yeah. There's the Grand Prix in Italy.
That's
there is a Grand Prix in Italy.
There is.
Yeah, but have you seen it live on TV before? I've seen the race. They're there, aren't they? I've seen the flags and all. They do their apple flag in Italy, they. Brilliant.
I like the pictures.
Thank you.
Yes.
you can see the volcano. There is, it's the only country in Europe where there is active volcano. It means that they can wake up anytime, really. They are called Etna, Vesuvio, and Stromboli. And they are huge and really impressive. So it's the only country in Europe where there is some that are possibly going to be awake one day. So it's really beautiful. Next slide, please, Phil, thank you.
Pizza Tower, Venice is... It's not France. Pizza Tower, Venice is France. Venice is the car, Ferrari, Maserati, Lamborghini.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Chris.
That's in Rome, isn't it?
Next slide, please, Phil.
So as well, Italy is famous for Romeo and Juliet. You might have read the book, seen it at the theater, or watched the film. And the actual balcony is in the town Verona. You can visit it if you go there. And next slide is, you might have seen the film. So this is the balcony scene with Romeo and Juliet. There is just a minute of it if you want to watch.
What film star? What film?
Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah.
Good film.
Cool. If people can mute their microphone so we can hear, that'd be good.
Oh, it is my lady. It is my love.
Hi, me.
Oh my goodness, that's cool.
Romeo. Where for out there, Romeo?
Romeo and Juliet. Never said before.
I mean. Or if thou wilt not, we would sworn my love and I'll no longer be a cat. But thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a monk.
Yes.
What's Montague?
I can't find Mrs. Grand Prix. What? Can't find Mrs. Grand Prix.
Monza.
Monza. Can't find it.
All right. British.
Well, we're on there, isn't it?
No, Monza. British one.
Yeah.
Nah,
you mean
Italian one, don't
we? In the Italian one, yeah. Monza. Good. It's a race, isn't it?
Yes.
It's a fastest race car.
So it's not working well, the video, is it?
It's
what, think what is not working.
Color is by any other
oh, there we are.
Romeo, doff thy name. Before thy name, which is no part of thee, take all myself.
I take thee thy word.
So I'm sure you've seen the film Romeo and Juliet before.
Yeah, never seen it before.
It is a beautiful love story and the war between two families as well.
Next slide, please, Phil.
I starred in it.
Thank you.
Oh, there we go again.
Right.
Can you speak Italian? If you know what they mean Italian, we'll open your mics.
No. I can't speak Italian.
Shall we try? We can try.
Okay then, Phil, next slide.
I can't speak Italian as well, I can't.
I can't speak it.
Hello.
Ciao. How do you, ciao is hello.
Ciao.
Ciao. Hello. Hello. Ciao.
Everyone try. Ciao.
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 Hello.
Ciao, Bella.
Ciao, Bella.
Ciao, Bella.
Ciao, Bella. Goodbye.
No.
Thank you.
Grazie.
Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie. Grazie saying Char on the phone to him. He was saying, what the heck?
Christina.
Benny.
Good. Yes, no.
Christina, yes.
C is yes. No is no.
Yes. No.
Okay.
That would become Jimmy.
I'm relaxing on these steps. Thank you very much in Italian.
I cannot hear that.
What's
up?
Scusami.
Scusami.
There is some good accent there.
Scusami.
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 Next slide, please, Phil.
I think there is one more.
Cumstatogi.
That
means, how are you?
How are you today?
Okay. I said that to me.
How are you, Stephen, when your dad rings tonight?
Tomorrow, I'm phoning him.
Next night, please, Phil.
Well done, everyone.
Well done, everyone.
Fabulous. Well done, guys.
Oh, yes, thank you.
These amazing quality products and the easy Google message.
Well, they're amazing.
Thank you, Phil. Next one.
So Kirsty was talking about the gelato earlier, and it is ice cream.
I love my ice cream. Next time I go to Italy, I want some ice cream.
Espresso coffee is strong and short and strong.
Is it called?
It's quite nice.
So you will have
short and strong.
Gemma, if you go to Italy, you will have to ask for a gelato.
Gelato.
See you, Christelle. I love ice cream, but I don't like coffee.
Espresso,
no, I don't like coffee.
That looks like strong coffee.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
It would wake you up straight away.
Okay, Phil, next slide.
Excuse me.
Yes, Liz.
That's gorgeous.
Yeah.
I'm gonna try the firm cheeses. That's a good one.
Yeah, I'm sure we are starting to get hungry.
Excuse
right?
me.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's nice pizza.
Pizza.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
You like pizza?
Yes.
Pizza's calzone and focaccia.
Okay,
I've had my lunch.
You've had your lunch.
I haven't. I'm really hungry, but I just had my lunch.
That's lovely pizza.
We can always eat a gelato. You don't need to be hungry.
That's gorgeous.
Some gelato. Shall we look at the next
one? Isabel.
So let's have a look. I'm not going to demonstrate how to do a pizza dough, but there is a great video about a challenge about making a pizza dough. Let's have a look.
Right.
Yeah, can everyone mute their microphones so we can hear the video again? So if everyone can mute their microphones and then we'll be able to hear.
I don't need to mute.
Self-tanned, right? Okay.
I'm just checking. Gemma, can you mute your microphone for us?
Yes, mine's muted, Phil. Thank you.
It's called Almond.
There's somebody still there. I can hear somebody talking, so I'm just looking. Luke, I'm just going to mute yours. Thank you.
It looks like a scary face a little bit on this side. Do you like see the eyes? Like a horror movie. Oh my God.
Toss the pizza dough.
Like in the air?
Oh, this is gonna be a disaster. Okay, definitely gotta put flour on it.
There we go.
Well, that's probably way too much.
So I know you're supposed to like knead it. I think it's just like massaging it is what that means.
Ooh.
Come on,
Spread out.
Oh, this is so hard.
This isn't going well.
Got a lot to take out. Good thing I have this pizza dough.
Now the fun part. Do I...
Oh, flour in the eyes.
Maybe I'm doing it. It's tossing.
This is definitely not working. Am I supposed to sing while I'm doing this? Oh, no.
I have no idea how to toss this. I'm aging 20 years because of the stress.
Okay.
We're going to toss.
I just did this weekend.
With pizza dough, generally, you don't use flour to roll out your dough. You use a little bit of oil because it gives you a nice crispy crust. What you want to do is just use your fingertips and start pressing from the middle.
Don't want to pull it too hard. Take your time.
I like to do this to help stretch it out a little bit.
Kind of like gravity do its work.
Get it on your knuckles and let it like drag down, like let the weight of it do its own job.
You just like shove your fists in there.
Spin it. Woo! Keep doing it. Sometimes I use both hands and do something like that.
I feel like a tragedy.
Look at, isn't that attractive?
We're going to toss pizza dough, which is kind of a misnomer a little. I'm really going to stretch this out with just a little bit of tossing. So we're starting with a good pizza dough. So I'm going to actually put it directly into this bowl of flour. And I'm going to put it onto my board and have a little bit of extra flour on top, okay? First, I'm going to pat it down and stretch it, right? A lot of people want to use a rolling pin. You don't want to use a rolling pin because that rolls out all the air pockets. It's going to be more like a crisp bread or a flat bread than a pizza. So I have my flour, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to start to press down my edges, continually turning it with the tips of my fingers. And so then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start to stretch the dough with my hands. Then, instead of tossing it for the most part, I'm gonna pick it up and start to let the gravity do its work, do the work for me, okay? If you want, you can put it on the backs of your hands, and I'm gonna just lightly pull. When you stretch the dough like this, you wanna use your knuckles, not your fingers. Your fingers are pointing, and they're gonna pop through the dough. Basically, you're just tossing it to move it around with your knuckles, okay? So now that I got it to a point where I have a nice crust, it's fairly thin, I can start to cook it. And you can just throw it on your pan now, and it's ready to go. Ta-da!
Wow. Get the muscles in there.
Here we go. Right, shall we go to the next slide, Phil? I've never tried to do that. Have you tried that? No, maybe one day we need to do the challenge.
I like to do that. I like to.
Yeah, you can. Okay. Now you know what the right technique is.
Yes.
Definitely something to try.
Nice pizza.
Yeah, then you can do any toppings.
I am trying to go to the next slide.
Okay.
It looks like a fairy face a little bit on this side.
He puts the bags, then.
Oh, pasta. Yummy. I love pasta.
So here we go. So Italy is obviously very famous for its food, including all the different pasta, lasagna. So many possibilities. Look at that. Make me so hungry.
I love pasta.
Do you?
And spaghetti as well, up the top.
Nice. Shall we go to the next one, Phil? Thank you.
Next thing, what you had to cook with us. Let me think. If I had a choice, I'd like to cook that
actually,
one.
Actually, what would you like to cook with us? Let's vote.
So
how are we going to vote? And the most votes we get to cook next week, and the other two are...
Well, I'd like to do carbonara 1 week, next week.
Okay, hands up for lasagna.
Can I put everyone back on the main screen, do you think?
Please, Phil.
and we can count.
Yes, thank you.
So just before I do that, what you're being asked to do is next week, they're going to show us how to cook one of these meals. It's going to be a live cooking demonstration.
Oh, wow.
What you're being asked to is decide whether you want to be shown how to cook lasagna, carbonara, or chicken...
Arrabbiata.
You've got three choices.
My favorite one is carbonara. I like it.
Well,
hang on, I'm looking how many people we've got. Are you voting, Alex? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21 people that I can see.
So, okay, I can write down the number. Shall we go one screen by one screen?
Yeah, let's go round and let's hear from everyone.
That's easy.
That's dandy, I'm not quite sure as well.
So Harriet, who you what? Which dish are you going for?
I'm going to go for the second one.
Carbonara?
Yeah.
I'm doing carbonara as well.
Carbonara.
Yeah. Right, Maxine, yes, who are you going for?
Maxine, do you know how to unmute?
Yes, Dave, I love to do carbonara, thank you.
We've got yours, Gemma. Gemma's a carbonara as well. We've got Gemma's.
Okay. Oh, Maxine, you are...
Oh, Maxine, go for it. Which one?
Lasagna, the first one.
Lasagna. Okay. Amy. Luke.
Carbonara, think it's how I told you.
Yes, carbonara, yes, me. I love that.
Stephen.
Carbonara.
No, I don't look funny then.
Carbonara for Debbie as well.
Yeah.
And carbonara for Suzette as well.
Yes, we've got a winner.
Yay!
Yeah, well,
we're
going to
get everyone else's vote. Let's get everyone else's vote. Keziah.
Carbonara, please.
Vicky.
Lasagna.
Lasagna. Okay. Luke.
Yes.
Which dish?
I don't know.
Lasagna, carbonara, or what's the last one?
Arrabbiata.
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 Yeah, good choice.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, Andrew, what are you voting for, son?
The third one, the chicken parrabbiata.
Oh, arrabbiata.
Emily, what are you choosing?
Carbonara.
Oh, wow.
I actually made chicken arrabbiata last night for the first time, and I had four empty plates in my house, so I'm going to do chicken arrabbiata.
Yay. Oh, wow.
What about you, Phil?
I'm going for arrabbiata as well. Oh, we're having a late surge. Who's that on the next screen? I can't quite see. Galaxy Tab A. Can you unmute yourselves?
What's upside down?
Maybe not.
No.
And the other Galaxy Tab A, which is upside down.
Can you unmute?
I do recognise it's from Grange, isn't it? Or Grange or Oaklands. And Zoe. What about your choice? Would you like lasagna, carbonara, or arrabbiata? Which one? The first one, the second one? The second one. Third, arrabbiata. And I don't know who's on 789117, but if you want to unmute, Well, I think that's all of the votes that we can capture at the moment. So
Carbonara has won. Carbonara it is.
So what was the score?
Yes.
I want to know by how many. What was the score?
We've got 9 for Carbonara.
Yes.
A 5 for Arabia. Carbonara wins.
Carbonara wins, Emily. Well done.
That's
going to
be yummy.
No, next week, if you join us at the same time next week, ready to watch,
2 o'clock.
You can join in. And maybe if we can get the ingredients out to people before so that they can cook it in the evening, maybe. So if you, Christelle and Alex, if you get an ingredient list sent to me, I can get it sent out before.
Hey, thank you.
Yes, we will.
Great stuff. Is that the end, guys?
That's the end of the presentation.
That's the end, right? Thank you.
Well, before we give a massive opportunity TV round of applause to Alex and Christelle, can I just remind you, on Monday at 10 o'clock, it's a really great session. It's called Fit and Fun, and it's a great way to start Monday morning. We do some really gentle exercises. And this Monday, we've got Sarah from Larchfield, who's going to do some yoga with us. So you need to come in comfortable clothes, have some space, and get ready to do some yoga.
Then in the afternoon, 3 o'clock, it's fun facts.
Next week, can you send me the link for next week?
Okay, thank you, Christelle.
I'll be sending posters out later today about all of next week's activities.
I will. Please,
before we go, can we give a massive Opportunity TV round of applause for the amazing, the wonderful, the marvellous Alex and Christelle. Right, everyone, you know what to do. You've got to stay home, you've got to stay safe, you've got to look after yourselves, and you've got to look after each other, and come back at 10 o'clock.
Have
a great weekend, everyone.
Bye, Emily.